Welcome back to the Dividend Diplomats YouTube channel. You got Bert the Hurt Locker over here.
You got Big L over here. And guess what, everybody? We're here to talk to you about some of our dividend stock purchases. So before we do that, you know the drill. Smash that subscribe button. Give us a thumbs up so we can keep delivering dividend investing news to you. And so we can tell you about dividend increases, financial freedom, and our dividend stock purchases.
And I haven't done it in a while, but this video goes out to all the millions and millions of dividend investors out there. Bert and I are talking to you about the dividend stocks we bought during the week of February 22nd. We put the money where the mouth is. We put the cash to the paper to the cash, the ass to the can, and the rock bottom on the floor.
It's exactly right, Lanny. We practice what we preach. We buy the dividend stocks we talk about. We're not just selling you something on this YouTube channel that we're not willing to do ourselves. And that's what we've always enjoyed with all the blogs and videos we've watched over the years. So please let us know what stocks you purchased too, as well as we go through this, because we love hearing about them.
And that's the bottom line, because Bert said so.
Exactly. So how do we find these undervalued dividend stocks? Using our stock screener, the Dividend Diplomats Dividend Stock Screener, trademark pending. Of course, so what are they? Three metrics.
First metric is the price to earnings ratio, which is taking the stock price, and we like to use the projected earnings per share, what the analysts are seeing. So that's going to show you if it's under or overvalued. And again, you kind of compare that to the S&P 500, which is trading at over 35 to 40 times earnings. And then you can also look at the industry, as a lot of our commenters have been asking. Yes, we do that. So again, that's the price to earnings is the first metric. And that second metric is what, Bert?
The second metric is the dividend payout ratio less than 60%. We want to make sure that a company has the ability to continue paying and growing a dividend income going forward. If you pay more than you earn, that's not sustainable. So the dividend payout ratio helps you analyze the safety of a dividend. And ideally, we think a perfect dividend payout ratio is between 40 and 60%, as that allows a company to reinvest its earnings in the business to continue growing earnings going forward, and let's be honest, paying us as shareholders too. That's the perfect balance.
And that third dividend metric is dividend growth and that dividend growth rate on average. We like to look at companies that have that consistent trend of not only just paying that dividend, but on that journey to financial freedom, you want that dividend to grow. So we look at the growth. How many years? You know, how long have they done it nonstop? There's the dividend aristocrat status, 25 plus years. But then we look at, we don't want a dividend stock that, you know, maybe pays a 2 to 3% yield and only grows at 0.5% to 1%. We like to look at that growth rate on average to make sure that it makes sense, Bert.
Yeah, so in summary, I would be a terrible dividend growth stock because I stopped growing a long time ago and I didn't grow a lot. So
I thought you had that late, you know, midlife potential growth spurt.
It's always there, but hey, we can always increase our dividend in the future.
He's drinking the 2 glasses of milk a day.
Yep, but we'll see one day.
And Bert just says, hey, take it easy, you know?
That's exactly what I said. Yeah, but anyway.
We look at that bonus metric, Bert.
Yeah, the dividend yield. We want to make sure the company passes the first three metrics first, but of course we look at the dividend yield too, because we want to make sure we're getting a nice return on our money. Typically, you look for companies that are yielding more than the S&P 500, which has a dividend yield usually between 1.5 and 1.7%.
All right, so you got the rundown, how we look for stocks, how we buy them. Now it's to tell you, during this past week, February 22nd through February 26th, what stocks Bert and his wife bought and what stocks myself and my wife bought. And I'll kick things off because, again, there's one that's a staple on every video that you've seen each week.
GameStop. Kidding. No, what is it, Lanny?
If only it was GameStop. Shout out to all the, you know, Wall Street bets out there. Keep doing your thing. Love seeing the battle of the David versus Goliath. But the consistent weekly purchase that my wife and I do, again, it's a broken record at this point. Vanguard, ticker symbol VYM for Vanguard's high dividend yield ETF. Why do we keep buying this? Since what, late July, early August, my wife and I, each Monday, it's to take the emotion and timing out of the market, because you can't time the market. It's all about time in the market. And without, you know, knowing what direction this market is going, especially with the Wall Street bets, especially with instances such as that, you know, you can't predict what's going to happen in the stock market.
No, and it's a nice low expense ratio ETF offered by Vanguard. I'll put up the top holdings here in the video. You can see them now. They're great dividend stocks that this fund invests in,
too. I love those stocks, in the words of Jim Cramer.
Yeah, they are. I mean, they're stocks that we would consider investing in individually, so Lanny's just making the decision easy and every week just buying some VYM.
So we buy 3 shares between my wife and I. So we each bought 3 shares of VYM. Thank God the price we got it at was $96.02, because this ETF just keeps on roaring forward. Overall, you know, again, we deployed, gosh, a total capital, you know, when I do the math, we totaled $576, and we added, again, close to $17.50 in forward income at a total dividend yield of 3.03%.
Fantastic job, Lanny. That's another great purchase. I can't say it enough.
So, Burr, what was that first one?
Yeah, I want
the back to the basics here with your favorite industry.
Lanny challenged me last week. I initiated a position in Dimeco Bank, ticker symbol DIMC.
Thanks to that commenter.
I bought 15 shares last week. Lanny said, I challenge you to get to 30. So what did I do? I got to 30
shares.
He got to 30. Yeah, the share price went down. So this is a nice little community bank in eastern Pennsylvania. Great asset size, right in the sweet spot of less than $5 billion that we like. Great dividend yield, 4% at the time of my purchase. Strong dividend history. They've increased their dividend a lot recently. So I added 15 shares at $33.75, adding $506 to my position. Increased my forward income another $20.40.
Bird, guess what? Get to 50 shares.
Get the table.
Yeah. No, I'm kidding. That's the fuck. Get the 50 shares,
Bert. I'll see what I can do this week. I mean, if the price keeps falling, I'm just going to keep buying more of this bank because I like it.
Let's go, Bert. Challenge.
Yeah, and if you ever want to learn more about banking, I'm sure Lanny and I would love to tell you more about that. So ask away in the comment section.
So the next day, on Tuesday, on the 23rd of February, we got 1 share of this top 5 foundation stock for your portfolio. And actually, Bert will talk about this company as well, because he may have edged me out on this one.
Yeah.
So in my wife's account, we bought 1 share, Consolidated Edison, ticker symbol ED, and this is one of the long-term utility companies. Mr. Lightbulb himself, Thomas Edison. We got 1 share at $67.15, adding $3.06 in forward income at a dividend yield of 4.56%.
Fantastic stuff. And as Lanny alluded to, I also bought Consolidated Edison a couple days later in the week. We bought 2 shares from my portfolio at a price of, drumroll please, 66.959. I love when they have so many fractional shares in your purchase price. But yeah, we added $6.12 to our forward dividend income. So yeah, I barely edged out Lanny's wife this week. As you can see, the utility stocks are just getting hammered. They're slowly decreasing. So for me, this is an easy decision. Just keep adding to one of our 5 foundation stocks, building up that position. The company's been around forever. They've paid a dividend for a long time in a sector that, quite frankly, everybody needs to survive.
This next stock that I bought, I actually bought in 3 different increments. You know, one time on Tuesday, I did it again on a Wednesday, and then I wasn't done yet, and I went ham on a Friday. Warren Buffett, you know, him and I, he's been looking at what I'm doing and what I'm buying. He's been looking at what Bert's buying. You know, if you haven't seen our Warren Buffett video, click the link above, but we all know that he's been increasing his position in this Cincinnati institution called Kroger, the nice grocer down south, Bert, ticker symbol KR.
I love this purchase, Lanny. It's a great, large national grocery chain, and they're one of the few that actually evolved with the pandemic. They were one of the leaders in helping people still get groceries and doing it in a safe manner in 2020. So not every chain's gonna lose out to some of your Walmarts, your Targets. They're one that has been positioned well and adjusted accordingly. So how many shares did you buy over these days, Lanny?
So first, on a Tuesday, you know, I bought 3 shares of Kroger at $33, $99 total, adding $2.16. Then on Wednesday, I bought 2 more shares at $32.75, so slightly less, for a total of $55.50, adding $1.44 in income. Then on Friday, I said, okay, I bought 5, time to double that. I bought 10 more shares on Friday.
Wow, so 15 shares total during the week.
15 shares total, about 10 more at $32.25, total price of $322.50, adding $7.20. So in total, I know I'm speaking very fast because this is a lot. In total, for my Kroger, again, ticker symbol KR, in total, I deployed a capital of $487 in Kroger for 15 shares, adding just over $10 to my forward dividend income.
That's fantastic. So the average yield is probably right around 2.2% on your purchase, which beats the S&P 500. and is well above that online savings account you're doing. And it's a nice company. I mean, it's great for you to continue building your position to one day get a large full position in Kroger.
They had an over, you know, I think 12% increase last year. And, you know, I do see better things even happening this year as they've been a dominant support in the pandemic time period.
Yeah, so we only had one more purchase in our portfolio. My wife's been slowly building a position in Cardinal Health. So we added five more shares this week on, I think it was Wednesday. Was that the day the 25th was? I can't even remember.
It was Thursday.
Oh, that was Thursday. Yeah, so on Thursday we added five shares of Cardinal Health.
Aristocrat.
Yeah, Aristocrat. The price keeps falling, so I'm going to continue lowering her cost basis in this position. We bought them at $52.59. So that's, what, just over $260 added. So we had another $9.72 to her income. Our yield on the purchase was 3.7%. So,
nice. Yeah, so double the S&P 500.
Yep, it's been a stock that's been on my watch list recently, and I just like the company. Low P ratio, nice payout, as you said, an Aristocrat. So hey, we'll just keep slowly but surely buying if the price falls.
Is that a dividend increase coming up next quarter, Bert?
Yes, it is, Lanny. And trust me, we're going to enjoy every single one of the cents that we're going to get on the increase. But you weren't done, were you?
I was not done. I said, I'm still on the ring. I'm going 12 rounds in this dividend purchase knockout round. but you've heard that Warren Buffett as well also invested over $8 billion in this telecommunications company. You know, Bert and I, we've been buying now for a while. I've been buying this company for months. It's Verizon Communications, ticker symbol VZ. I bought four more shares on Friday at, you know, I had a limit order in at $56, so it triggered. $224 in capital was deployed. I added $10.04 in forward income at a yield of 4.48%.
Fantastic. So yeah, Buffett, you're welcome, and we're still buying too at these prices.
And if you haven't watched the video on that we released over the weekend about AT&T's big news, I wasn't done yet. I did a little chip shot putt because I had a limit order at $28 for AT&T. I bought one share, adding $2.08 at a yield of over 7.4%.
Fantastic price to pick up one for AT&T.
I mean, I knew $28 is kind of like my sweet spot. If it goes lower, maybe in under 27, I'll look at, I have a large position, so I don't want to keep going.
Hey, but just be a patient hitter, wait for your pitch. And when it's thrown over the plate, just smash out of the park.
Well, Bert, you want to give us a summary of your dividend stock purchase total?
Yep, it was only three stocks. We added Cardinal Health, Dimeco Bank, and Consolidated Edison. In total, we added $903 to our portfolio, which I guess, yeah, it added up a lot because of those 15 shares of Dimeco. And then that added $36.24 of dividend income, an average yield of 4.01% on the purchase.
Nice yield, wow.
Oh, thanks, what about you, Lanny?
Well, we deployed about $1,382 this week at a yield on average of 3.14%, which is actually slightly above the portfolio yield that we have on average. So that's nice that we're getting maybe a little bit of a pickup there. Total dividend income added $43.44, almost $4 a month in extra dividends. Again, yeah, pretty happy with the positions. I'm still looking at, you know, VYM come Monday. You know, hopefully they stay below $100 a share. You know, Kroger, I still am interested in. Verizon, I'm still interested in.
Yeah, these are great stocks at these prices. So we'll just keep buying if the metrics continue to remain right. It's pretty simple, right? You crunch the numbers, you see what passes your screener. And if you want to, just start adding money to great dividend stocks in your portfolio.
I might have to take my kidney out to see if I can find some more money to buy some dividend stocks.
Hey, it is what it is. You got to do what you got to do, Lanny. So please let us all know in the comment section, what stocks have you been buying? What do you think of our purchases as well? And let us know what stocks are on your watch list too, so maybe we can add one to our watch list for March.
Again, the name of the game is to keep buying income producing assets. Dividend growth stocks, to Bert and I, is like the main point as we reach financial freedom. We love doing this week after week because guess what? The proof is here in the pudding. We don't just make videos and talk about stuff. We're here on this journey together. And us doing this keeps us in check, hopefully keeps you in check, and lets you know that this is possible. We are adding income here.
Yeah, and if you aren't tired of listening to us by now, please make sure you subscribe to the channel. Give these videos a thumbs up so we can continue producing videos. Everybody, thank you so much for your support over the last year.
This is Bert and Lanny from the Dividend Diplomats.
Over and out.